extent that this size up further, because it's thinner, before it's up down to the same thickness, it'll look the same, basically. At this point, before you put it back in the fire, you're trying to formulate an idea of where you're going to hammer next. You're not trying to figure that out after you pull it out of the fire. Even though once I hammer it thin, it's cooled down, there's still plenty of heat where it was still thick, so I can keep working it. Now, you got to be careful about this. That's okay, I'll do that. Yeah. And be careful, you know, keep my mind on the work because it's already up to temperature already. That's going to be down to come down to 2.5 millimeters, so you can see we're going to, this is going to be a big old chunk of steel. But at this point, I'm ready to turn it around and now forge the blade. One thing we can do to make it easier to hold on to, we're actually going to put a bend in the tang. Because it's tapered and the tongs are tapered, so that's the tendency it wants to scoot out. However, put over the thick of the anvil, we put in a little bend which will straighten out afterwards. Now, whenever we hold it with the tongs, it makes 3 points of contact.